Well, here we go again, out here on the road again, and I can't wait to get back home to you. It feels like eternity since I've had you next to me, and I can't wait to get back home to you.
Thank you. hipster with. Come on, everybody, it's breaking news about a long gone daddy and blues way to get a rock, rockin' hillbilly. A rock, rock, rockin' hillbilly. Gonna roll into town and rock your city. A rock, rock, rockin' hillbilly. A rock, hillbilly. Gonna pop all your blues away. And a rockin' hillbilly. Gonna pop all your blues away. All right. How's everybody doing? Looks like we got some folks already in the chat. That's a good sign. Working on my technology and actually getting some buffer music and all that good stuff. Make sure I got everything muted the way it needs to be. Switching it around. It's walking a tightrope when you start playing around with these audio levels right in the middle. Does it have a malfunction echo or a rockabilly echo? Something don't look quite right on my side. We'll get this in just a minute. All right. There ain't gonna be a whole lot I can do about the static because I live in an old house. So. All right. Nothing like switching to a new thing. All right. Let's get this all sorted out. All right, yesterday was Chuck Berry's birthday, so how about we do a Chuck Berry song instead of messing around with this audio?
Maybelline, why can't you be true? Oh, Maybelline, why can't you be true? You just started back doing the things you used to do. I was motivating over the hill. I saw Maybelline in the Cougar field. Cadillac rolling on the open road, but ain't nothing out running my V8 4. Cadillac doing about 95, and we were bumper to bumper rolling side by side. Maybelline, why can't you be true? Oh, Maybelline, why can't you be true? You just started back doing the things you used to do. Cadillac pulled up to 104. The fog got hot, wouldn't be no more. It done got cloudy, started to rain. So I tooted my horn for the passing lane. The rainwater going all under my hood. I knew that would do it my motor good. Maybelline, why can't you be true? Oh, Maybelline, why can't you be true? You just started back doing the thing you used to do. Well, the heat went down, the motor cooled down, and that's when I heard the highway sound. Cadillac sitting like a ton of lead, 110 half a mile ahead. The Cadillac looking like a sizzling steel, and I caught Maybelline at the top of the hill. Maybelline, why can't you be true? Oh, Maybelline, why can't you be true? You just started back doing the thing you used to do. Can't you be true? Oh, Maybelline, why can't you be true? You just started back doing the thing you used to do. All right, little Chuck Berry to start things off. Like I said, yesterday was his birthday. I got a couple of those on my set list. Hopefully, well, some of what y'all might be hearing in the background too is my air conditioner. We're in that in-between stage down here in Georgia, and it gets awful stuffy back here in the back room down here at the pig farm. So, gotta kind of have something moving around back here. I won't make it through the whole thing. Well, thank you, Katie. I want to thank y'all for making the venture over here to YouTube. Like most of y'all that are in here already know that I'm ready to start moving away from Facebook. It's kind of a losing battle over there. The old saying is, if the game's rigged, the only way you can beat the rig is to not play the game. So I'm gonna join Joey and kind of starting to move away from there and start using some of these other avenues. Maybe we'll inspire some other people to walk away from it too. But if y'all got any y'all want to hear, any regular ones or something you think I might be doing, you know, I might can do. Got your notifications for the tips there. That's a good start. So, let's see, what else do we want to go next? Like I said, I got a couple of Chuck Berry songs on here. I figured we should do a couple of them, since he had a birthday. I think he would have been 94, yesterday. I think we lost him 3 or 4 years ago. He got on up there before he checked out, so that's always nice. How about an original? I know I had the CD playing, the songs off the CD playing to bring it in. I don't think I had this one going, so we'll how about a little trifle on here? Come from the Texas coast, she's a real good gal and I love the most. Her name is Trifalonia, from down in Houston town. Her name is Trifalonia, but she don't run around. tell me that her name is strange, but I tell them real quick she don't play no games. And if you drive full on ya, she pretty ass to me. And she tell you, brother, that she belongs with me. TV, no juking around, she's right here with me. Me and drive for Lonya, we're staying in the night. My sweet drive for Lonya, well, she always treats me right. Her name is Driver Lonely, but she don't run around. I said her name is Driver Lonely, but she don't run around. A little Driver Lonely there from the new Lucky Jones record. If you ain't got you one of them yet, you can go to LuckyJonesMusic.com and grab you one. You can download it, you can buy the CD. All that good stuff. You can stream it here on YouTube. I got all of them but one. The last single for the record. If you hadn't heard it yet, bought the record and heard it yet, there's still one more single to be released. It'll be released on November 6th. It'll be on Spotify, YouTube, and all that kind of stuff. But if you want to hear it before then, you can buy the record. I think most everybody in here has probably already got it, though. Oh, hey, Kelly. Glad you made it. How's your mama doing? Hope she's getting better. All right. Well, now that I've did that little... That little spiel we did in the original, we tried to sell a record, but like I said, I think most of y'all already have it. And I got to find, I know Joey talks about getting this stuff on the right place on the screen. I know I complain about Facebook not giving me enough information, but I think YouTube might be giving me a little more than I want. Oh, hey, Mike. Mike Pass out in California. All right. Well, since I brought that song up, we got Old Blue going tonight. That's probably a little bit of the static too. Old Blue's a little more noisy than the green one. Since I brought up that last single, it's called Why Sweet Baby, and if you hadn't heard it yet, like I said, it'll be out November 6th. It's on the CD now if you want it, and I'm about to play it for you without a band. Tell me why, sweet baby, don't you love me like you used to do? I give you all my loving and all you do is make me blue. You know I love you, baby, and I swear it's true, but I can't seem to get along with you. Tell me why, sweet baby, don't you love me like you used to do? Tell me why, sweet baby, don't you always gotta make me cry? And when you can't find a door when you come home at night, I love you, baby, till the day I die. Then I caught you running around with another guy. Tell me why, sweet baby, do you always gotta make me cry? Oh, well, I try, just no use. I'm gonna pack your bag and cut you loose. I had enough, sweet baby, but we are through. Ooh, you know I love you, baby, and I swear it's true, but I can't seem to get along with you. Tell me why, sweet baby, don't you love me like you used to do? Yeah. to show you to that door. And don't you try, sweet baby, to come around here no more. You know it just can't be like it was before, when I was up all night and walking the floor. So bye bye, sweet baby, don't you come around here no more. Just no use. I'm gonna pack your bag and cut you loose. I've had enough, sweet baby, but we are through. Ooh, you know I love you, baby, and I swear it's true, but I can't seem to get along with you. Tell me why, sweet baby, don't you love me like you used to do? Tell me why, sweet baby, don't you love me like you used to do?
Something kind of like that. Wait, Marty. Glad to see you made it over here to into YouTube land. Hopefully we can just keep on trucking along over here and leave Facebook behind for a little while. Yeah, Margaret, that was cool that you posted all those videos. If you hadn't If you wanted to see some video of the big old Joey Alcorn Lucky Jones show from Saturday night, friend up Margaret over there, Margaret Lewis, and she's posted up quite a few live videos from the show the other night. I was talking to Kelly on the Patreon earlier, and she heard the same thing I heard. The guy that mixed it was pretty fond of Joey's acoustic guitar. He had that up pretty loud, and he kept telling me on breaks. He's like, man, can you do something to boost your solos when you play? Like, it sounds okay when you're playing with everybody else, but then when you go to do the solo, we can't hear you. And then when I heard the videos, I was like, well, you can't hear because you got the acoustic too loud. It covers such a broad sound spectrum. When you got that thing too loud, you can't really hear much anything else. But that's how it goes sometimes. That's why us guitar players usually get in trouble for playing too loud, because if you don't play too loud, then nobody can hear you. That's pretty much your two options when you play it live. All right. Let's see. I didn't make much of a set list. I got these old ones here I can kind of look at too. I'm old school too. Joey's got all these software and apps and all that kind of stuff. I got a little notepad. Mike Bass, I need to dip them fingers in a tub of water. I hear you. Oh, I know what I wanted to do. Where'd it go? Yeah. I want to do a Buddy Holly song.
Every day it's getting closer, going faster than a roller coaster. Love like yours will surely come my way. Hey, hey, hey. Every day it's getting faster, everyone says go ahead and ask her. Love like yours will surely come my way. Hey, hey, hey. Every day is a little longer, every way love's a little stronger. Come what may, did you ever long for true love from me? Every day it's getting closer, going faster than a roller coaster. Love like yours will surely come my way. Than a roller coaster, love
like you, will surely come my way. Hey, something like that. I figured you like that one, Kelly. I know you've requested that one before. I like playing that song. I like kind of amping it up a little bit, too. Well, all right, Murdy. Well, we'll try to get you some rocking in before it dies on you. I'm bad about letting mine die before I come in here to do this and then forgetting my cable, because I got to use my hotspot on my phone to stream, because I get decent download speed, but my upload speed's not really good enough to stream, so I had to use the phone to do it. But whatever works. I think Kelly said something about doing Rock This Town, so let's do it. Alright, gonna pick you up a 10, gonna hand you over 2. Well, your mama don't know what I'm gonna say for you, but that's alright, because we're looking as cool as we do. Well, found you the place that really didn't look half bad. I had a whiskey on the rock, chained up a dollar for the jukebox. Well, I put a quarter right into that can, but all it played was disco, man. Come on, pretty baby, let's get out of here right away. We're gonna rock this town, rock it inside out. We're gonna rock this town, make them scream and shout. Let's rock, the rock, the rock, man, rock. We're gonna rock till we fall, we're gonna roll till we drop. We're gonna rock this town, we're gonna rock it inside out. Done that one on the regular Gretchen a long time. I usually do it on the baritone. I didn't get the baritone out because I'm kind of in the middle of working on it. I got a new set of GHS strings for it, and I'm doing a little bit of setup work on it and all that good stuff to because it's still got some new on it. But yeah, I got a new set of GHS strings to put on. Well, actually, these are for this guitar, but I figured they've been good to me, so I'll just start kind of waving a pack in front of everybody when we. Yes, Taylor. There's a the cool part about the deal with GHS strings and John Moody, who's my rep there. He told me his favorite thing about. When I contacted him, as I told him, I was like, I'm not bullcrapping you here. I've been using GHS strings for about 25 years. Like when I became a professional musician when I was about 15 years old playing punk rock. And And you, as you can imagine, a 15-year-old kid playing punk rock probably is going to break a lot of guitar strings. And punk rock doesn't pay a lot of money, and I was 15 years old. So you do the math that I couldn't really afford to be breaking a bunch of guitar strings. So when we went out on the road, I could go, if we were going to be out for about a month, I could buy five packs of boomers and usually come home with two packs. But I could take five to be safe. And a lot of times I would change strings just because they started to get dead. And but these things have been, they're the most, to me, they're the most reliable strings. And that's why I contacted them about maybe doing some kind of deal, because I like them. And if I can do a deal with them, then by all means, let's do it. If they would have said no, I would have just kept using their strings and just moved on. It's like Joey said, I don't want to, I wasn't like just trying to get a string deal, but if I can get one with them, I'll take it. And I'm going to open this up to show you. I don't know if anybody else plays guitar in here, but there's a really big reason why these strings are way head and shoulders above everybody else nowadays. Everybody's gone to these environmental friendly packaging for the strings, which means that you get one pouch like this, and there's another pouch inside of it that's sealed so they don't get, the strings don't oxidize and get corroded. But it's all the strings are wound together in one package. So if you need one string out of that package, it's terrible because you got to unwind six strings just to use one. GHS gives you six individual packages for your strings. I don't know anybody else that's still doing that, and it drives me nuts. You know, anytime I've had to use a different kind of strings, I'm like, yep, I'll never go back to doing that because it's ridiculous. But yeah, that's besides how long they last and how good they sound. The fact that you get six little nitrogen-sealed envelopes, you know, to keep the strings separated is worth every penny. All right, I guess my GHS ad is over. Oh. How about another Chuck Berry song since he had a birthday yesterday? Well, Joey likes to play this one with me. I like playing it by myself though, because I get to play it in B flat. We gotta get Joey a capo so he can play in B flat. When I play with him, I gotta do Trifolonia out of A and do the Chuck Berry songs out of A, and it's like. Ernest Tubb did this one out of A, and it sounds okay, but it's the Chuck Berry stuff sounds better in B flat. This one's called 30 Days. I'm gonna give you 30 days to get back home. I done called up a gypsy woman on the telephone. You're gonna send out a worldwide hoodoo. That'll be the very thing that'll suit you. I'm gonna see that you'll be back home in 30 days. Oh, 30 days, oh, 30 days. I'm gonna see that you'll be back home in 30 days. Yeah, she gonna send out a worldwide hoodoo. That'll be the very thing that'll suit you. I'm gonna see that you'll be back home in 30 days. Well, I talked to the judge in private early this morning, and he took me to the sheriff's office to sign a warrant. I'm gonna put a cross charge against you, and that'll be the very thing that'll send you. I'm gonna see that you'll be back home in 30 days. Oh, 30 days. Oh, 30 days. I'm gonna see that you'll be back home in 30 days. Yeah, we're gonna put a cross charge against you, and that'll be the very thing that'll send you. I'm gonna see that you'll be back home in 30 days. No satisfaction from the judge. I'm gonna take it to the FBI as a personal grudge. They don't give me no consolation. I'm gonna take it to the United Nations. I'm gonna see that you'll be back home in 30 days. Oh, 30 days. Oh, 30 days. I'm gonna see that you'll be back home in 30 days. They don't give me no consolation. I'm gonna take it to the United Nations. I'm gonna see that you'll be back home in 30 days. That one's better with a band because it's got background vocals and all that kind of stuff. Hopefully some of y'all were singing along at home, giving them echoes out. 30 days! Yeah, Sean, I love the Blue Grinch, man. I'm not sure if I like it as much as Kelly does, but I do like it a lot. Yeah, Kelly, I put that one on the list. Kelly wants to hear. I hear you talking. My brother hollered it out at the show on Saturday, and I was like, well, I could play it, but I don't think Joey's ever actually played it, and he only sang it once, standing like right there with the singing into the microphone down here at the pig farm. So Katie, do they think you just started going crazy, or is that a new development? Yeah, Sean, I'll do Come On Everybody just after I do this. I'm gonna do this original from the record. Well, it's not an original, it's from the record. It's an original by Farron Young. Called I Hear You Talking. I'm not gonna play the lead part, it sounds kinda dumb by itself.
Well, you want me to come back and love you again. I hear you talking, but your words ain't coming in. You want me to be something that I ain't never been. I hear you talking, but your words ain't coming in. I learned a lesson, you taught it to me. I might be a guessing, but I think you made a fool of me. Well, you should have thought of the way you'd feel before you were untrue. I hear you talking, but your words ain't coming through. Talking, but your words ain't coming in. You want me to be something that I ain't never been. I hear you talking, but your words ain't coming in. I guess I'm lucky that I found out so soon, 'cause this heart of mine was falling so in love with you. Well, best of health, lots of luck, I guess this is the end. I hear you talking, but your words ain't coming in. I hear you talking, but your words ain't coming in. I hear you talking, but your words ain't coming in.
All right, a little Farron Young from 1959. I hear you talking. And that one surprised me because I went to look up all the credits and everything for it, and I wasn't aware that Farron actually wrote that one. I was almost expecting to hear about man, his name's gone from me now, the guy that produced all the Buddy Holly records out in New Mexico. I was expecting to see his name or something on it because it's got that Buddy Holly feel to it. Especially that vocal melody. It sounds like something Buddy or somebody in Buddy Circle with a rope. But I've always, as soon as I heard that song, I knew it, and I heard it was fair, and I was like, man, that's, he didn't do a whole lot of songs like that, and I really like the way it feels. And of course it's fair and young singing, so of course the vocal side of it's going to be good. And Kelly's being nice and saying that we do justice to him. I don't know if anybody that's not named Farron Young does justice to a Farron Young song. But I appreciate you saying that. I was thinking about it. I gotta come up with a I know y'all have seen some of the live versions of Waylon and Willie doing Good Hearted Woman. And And Waylon will jump in and sing Willie's part and like pinch his nose and you know, and make fun of Willie. I need to come up with a Joey Alcorn parody voice for when I do that song by myself so I can make fun of Joey on his part. I don't know. I have to work on that, and I don't know if I really feel like it. Yes, a lot of Kelly's saying that there's some Hank in there too, and Farron's always had that unique delivery, but I can hear a little bit of Hank in the delivery too. There's a YouTube video of him doing that song. there's a YouTube video of him doing that song on one of those, I don't know if it's Town Hall Party or something like one of those, you know, the old variety shows. And he cranks his Farron delivery to 100, and it's like it's a whole different song. He stays, it's Farron, so he's on key, but like he's, I'm not sure which, you know, which number he's playing off of in the beat, but it's not the one. But he doesn't go off time. It's just a strange delivery. I don't know if I want to borrow Joey's hat. I think he sweats just as much as I do on stage. Oh man, that's why I just get my own. Get me one of them. Them I saw the light Hank Williams hats and toss it on. Let me see if I can remember Come On Everybody, Sean. It's been a minute since I played that one. Is it an E?
Well, come on, everybody, let's get together tonight. I got some money in my jeans and I'm really gonna spend it right. Music, you just can't sit still. If your brother won't rock, then your sister will.
Woo! Come on, everybody! Oh.
Oh, well, my baby's number one, but I'm gonna dance with 304. From the bare feet to slapping on the floor. Well, hell, when you hear the music, you just can't sit still. If your girl won't rock, then her sister will. Woo! Come on, everybody! Well, we really got a party, but we gotta put a guard outside. If my folks come home, I'm afraid they're gonna have my hide. There'll be no more movies for a week or two. No more running around with the usual crew. Who cares? Come on, everybody. Come on, everybody.
Like that. It's been a minute since I played that one. I don't think I've played that one since I did that Eddie Cochran show. And anytime I do those shows and I cram all those songs in together, I only retain about two or three of them.
Oh. Let's see.
Yeah, Katie, you gotta try. You gotta. I mean, I'm sure I'm capable of it, but you gotta try pretty hard to make an Eddie Cochran song sound bad. Oh, let's see. What else we want to do? What y'all want to hear? Go through my list here and see what we got. That's a good one to do. Now think about what you want to hear. I'm going to play a George Jones song. How about that?
Well, in North Carolina, way back in the hill, lived my old pappy and he had him a steel. He blew the white light until the sun went down, and then he filled him a jug and he passed it around. Mighty, mighty pleasing, your pappy corn squeezing. Ooh, white light. Well, the G-Man, T-Man, and Reverend Lewis too, searching for a place where he made his brew. They were looking, trying to book him, but my pappy kept on cooking. Ooh, white lightning. Well, the city slicker came and he said, I'm tough. I want a taste of that powerful stuff. He took once a slug and he drank it right down. And I heard him moaning as he hit the ground. Mighty, mighty pleasing, your pappy corn squeezing. Shoo, white lightning. Well, the G-Men, T-Men, Reverend Lewis too, searching for a place where he made his brew. They were looking, trying to book him, but my pappy kept on cooking. Shoo, white lightning. Well, I asked my old pappy why he called his brew white lightning instead of Mountain Dew. I took one sip and right away I knew, because my eyes bugged out and my face turned blue. Lightning started flashing, thunder started crashing. Ooh, white lightning. Oh, well, the G-Men, T-Men, Reverend Lewis too, searching for a place where he made his brew. They were looking, trying to book him, but my pappy kept on cooking. Ooh, white lightning.
Little George Jones.
Oh.
Speaking of George Jones, Tanya must have put her to bed. Figures if she wasn't, she probably would have already wandered in here. Y'all, we've had this Boston Terrier for almost 8 years now. And not until after the pandemic started. That dog ain't never barked. It's just a silent, she's just a little sweet, silent Boston Terrier named George Jones. And then about a month into the pandemic, she just decided that she was going to bark every time she wanted breakfast. So I'm sitting at the table finishing up my coffee, and it's not fast enough for her apparently. And now she just kind of just starts yelling at me. And then now it's for everything. She's ready to go outside. Come start yelling at you. If she's tired of you being in the back room tracking songs or making artwork, she comes in here and starts yelling at you. She's done picked up her old man card. It's just like, I'm going to say what I want to say, when I want to say it, and how loud I want to say it. But, yep, that's good old George Jones. Not the George Jones, the one that lives in this house.
Oh, I think I read Sleepwalk.
I welcome that. That gives me a break from singing. Shoot, man, if you want to ask for the same songs all the time, I'm fine with that because I only know so many. I'm trying to add some more to it so these streams don't get boring.
But everybody seems to like this one. I mean, I like playing it, so maybe that's why I think everybody likes
it. Well, thank you. Thank you, Kelly. Thank you for requesting it. Oh,
I can miss some stuff.
There you go, Mike. That's a good one to learn. Yeah, Mike Pass hit me up a couple months ago about finding a nice acoustic guitar that didn't cost too much money. And my go-to is that there's a couple of Yamaha models that you just can't beat in that price point. You know, they're just really good guitars. I'm glad to hear that you picked up a couple of songs already. That's good. Oh, there's Caleb. What's going on, man? Fashionably late. If I was the preacher, I'd make you come sit up on the front row now. Oh. Yeah, I see y'all got off on a little dog conversation, too. I'm catching up with the chat here. I've learned my lesson to not look at the comments while I'm playing Sleepwalk, because it messes me up every time. Not to say that I didn't mess up that time, because I messed up plenty. I got... all the little sliding is not working for me tonight because I got my hands are kind of sweaty. but let's see. I had another song in mind. I'm trying to catch up. Okay, I think I've seen what everybody got to say. I appreciate y'all being talkative in here. Oh yeah, it's the part where I get to be like Joey Alcorn and say. See, I don't know. He's got all this stuff up here where you can see who's liked the video and all that kind of stuff. Make sure you like the video if you know how to do it. It's a pain in the butt to do it while you're trying to chat, because if you're on the phone, you got to close the chat and do it. Don't worry about doing that. Just make sure you do it at some point, because this place runs on algorithms just like everything else, and runs on them algorithms. And I had a song in mind too, and I lost it. Oh. Now the phone's flashed a couple times, Kelly. Looks like I've been getting a couple of tips, so I appreciate you guys. Y'all know they help. I know y'all know they help because y'all give them. Oh, I feel like I missed a request somewhere. Either that or I had a song come to mind. Oh, I know which one I want to do. I had to play this one. It's so weird because I usually sing this one when I play with Heath or by myself or whatever. But when I play with Joey, this is one of his songs that he sings, and so I don't get to sing it as much. So I like doing it on the live streams. We ain't done any John R. Cash yet anyway, so I might as well do some. Now I told the weeping willow how to cry. I showed the clouds that I cover of a clear blue sky, and the tears that I cried for my baby are gonna flood you, big river, and I'm gonna sit right here until I die. I met her accidentally in St. Paul, Minnesota, and it tore me up every time I heard her draw, southern draw. And I heard my dream went back downstream to Wharton in Davenport, and I followed you, baby. When you took me to St. Louis later on down the river, freighter said she'd been here, but she's gone, boy, she's gone. I found her trail in Memphis,
but she just walked up the bluff. She raised a few eyebrows and then she went on down alone. Why don't you bat it down by Baton Rouge? Give it green, golden on. Take that woman on down to New Orleans, New Orleans. I go on, I've had enough. Dump my blues down in the Gulf. She loves you, they can never lie more than me. Talked the weeping willow how to cry, cry, cry. And I showed the clouds how to cover up a clear blue sky. And the tears that I cry for my baby are gonna flood you, big river. And I'm gonna sit right here until I die.
Little John R. Cash.
Whoo.
Man, when she sleeps, she sleeps hard. There ain't no waking her up. So if she's asleep, I don't know if that's going to happen. Whoo. Damn, I'm struggling tonight in the brain with a... finding some songs. I probably should have made a better set list, but I've been enjoying not making a set list and just kind of winging it. That is right. Usually when we start talking about all the Facebook stuff and the likes and clicks and all that kind of stuff, George gets a lot of clicks. If my algorithm's struggling, and I don't know, y'all probably have seen, some of y'all probably seen my pattern, but if I'm struggling and not getting a lot of likes and clicks on stuff, I'll just, even if it's something I'm posting, I don't have anything to do with the guitar, I will just take a pretty picture of a guitar or some guitars, and guitars get the likes, man. The guitar is the star of the show, and I think y'all figured out that I figured that out by a lot of my artwork for stuff. But I don't know if you can see this one. Let's do a little show and tell. But I caught a deal on one that was in kind of rough shape, and I kind of gutted it, but she's a little junior Gretsch Jet that I'm going to stick some TV Jones pickups in, and I'm going to do some cool stuff with it. I got most of the stuff already that I need to do it just sitting around, so this was kind of blue. I think they call it like gunmetal or something like that. But I got some work to do, and I've already had to kind of hack away at it and do some, huh? Oh, yeah. Oh, but anyway, that one should be gig ready in about a week or so. Uh-oh, there she is. That's all she wanted to do. Come here. Hey, you gonna be on my feet? You're tired. There you go, you got your George Jones sneeze. How about that? If that don't get the video a like, I don't know what will. Oh. Let's do one more Chuck Berry song. Let's wrap this thing up. That's probably about all I got for tonight. Oh. Like I said, I picked out a couple of Chuck songs since he had a birthday yesterday. We'll do this little lesser known deep cut from Chuck Berry to wrap things up. Thank you guys for tuning in and
and follow me. Follow me over here to YouTube. I think we'll all be better off if we start distancing ourselves from Facebook as much as we can. Like I said, the game's rigged over there, so I'm just not really going to play it that hard anymore. I'm gonna take my ball and play somewhere else. At least for the most part, you know, we'll still have some presence over there. But I'd like to see what we can do with some of these other platforms. But you know, once again, thank you guys. Thanks for the tips. Thanks for, you know, I know most of you guys are Patreon members too. And y'all have heard me say it before, but I don't know if I'll ever be able to say thank you enough for what you guys do. But I'll try every chance I get. So one more Chuck Berry song. Y'all probably never heard this one before.
Well, you're down in Louisiana, close to New Orleans. Way back up in the woods among the evergreen. There stood a log cabin made of earth and wood. Well, in the country boy named Johnny the Good. He never ever learned to read or write so well, but he could play the guitar just like he ringing a bell. Go, 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 Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go. Johnny the Good. He used to carry a guitar in a gunny sack. Those hippies out the tree by the railroad track. Those engineers see him sitting in the shade, coming with the rhythm that the drivers made. The people coming by, well, they will stop and say, oh my, well, that a little country boy can play. Go, 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 Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go. Johnny be good. Well, his mama told him someday you will be a man, and you will be the leader of a big old band. Many people coming from miles around to hear you play your music when the sun go down. Maybe someday your name will be in the light, saying Johnny be good tonight. Go, 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 go. Go, Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go. Johnny be good.
Thank you, guys. Yeah, you almost got me on that one, Caleb. I messed up and read that comment about Marty McFly. You guys might not be ready for that. Your kids are going to love it. Thanks, guys. Thanks for everything. Y'all have a good night. People that are on the Patreon, I don't know if y'all noticed this, be prepared. I'm going to be posting more over there, too. I'm going to try to do, like, 3 or 4 posts a week over there now. So make sure you got that app and everything too. We're going to start doing some more cool stuff there too. But y'all have a good evening, and I'll be a little more prepared next week. Maybe we'll do a longer show. But thank you guys for tuning in.
Again, out here on the road again, and I can't wait to get back home to you.